Hello and welcome to the Texas Tech National Signing Day Show. I'm Robert Giovanetti, joined by Texas Tech football coach Joey McGuire. And coach, you hit the ground running, what, how many days ago? Do you even remember how many days ago?
I really don't, man. It's been a blur.
It's been a blur, but you guys have been hitting the recruiting trail since then. And it kind of wraps up today here on early signing day. How do you feel overall about where you guys are?
I feel great, man. I thought the coaches and the staff did an incredible job. Made some great connections with kids, real relationships, and I think it saw the day with the class that we signed.
How hard is that? Because you also have to, when you come here to a new job, you're also having to recruit your current guys too, right?
No
you
doubt.
Got the current guys on the roster. How did you manage to balance that?
Well, you know, really, all of this, like I know the guys, the coach, the players, and the fans were like, who's going to be the coach? Who's going to be this coach? Who's going to be? And at the end of the day, I really try to focus on the current team and the recruits. You know, it's a player's game. And so we got to have really good players, and we wanted to keep the ones that we have, and we wanted to add to this family.
Hey, when you took the job and you were mapping out probably how this was going to look, did it go to script? Did anything throw you off script during all this?
I think, you know, it's funny. My wife and my son, my son came and visited, and He was saying, you know, Dad, this, and you'll give me pointers. And I was like, hey, G, take a deep breath, man. I have a plan. I've been working on this for a while. And he goes, I know, I'm just trying to help. So not really. I think it went according to plan. You know, we're going to talk about the class, and we're not done yet. But I think everybody's going to see what we tried to do in this class.
We'll talk to you a little bit later about what to expect, you know, before February, what used to be the traditional signing day show. When we come back, we'll take a look at the offensive class here. You're watching the National Signing Day Show here on ESPN Plus with Joey McGuire. Hello and welcome back to the Texas Tech National Signing Day Show. Robert Giovanetti with Joey McGuire. 19 new Red Raiders sign on this early signing period, and we're going to start on the offensive side of the ball. 6 new Red Raiders there on the offensive side. We're going to start with Bryson Donnell.
Bryson, running back from Tyler Legacy. Really excited about him. I mean, the biggest thing with him whenever I first met him, just the stature. I mean, 205 pounds right now coming out of high school. Had a really good career. Has a Coach Willis is his head coach and has done just a phenomenal job with him. But perfect fit. You know, he was committed to us. He's been committed to us for a long time. Coach Smith did just an incredible job of, you know, keeping him committed and them coming on their visit and seeing who we were, the new staff. I think he was really excited. I was fired up to get him.
With a guy like that, too, the continuity of Coach Smith probably helps a lot there as well.
Oh, that was huge. That was huge on some of these guys, but especially at that position, they had a great, great relationship. And so that was good to hang on to him.
Now, you're also going to have some mid-year transfers in this class.
And so Brady, I've known him for a long time. He's, you know, he's from the Metroplex, played at South Lake Carroll. Long wide receiver, had huge numbers last year, and can really run. I mean, he's got multiple 4.3s on laser 40s. And so I think he's a guy. The thing that I like about him, he's a coach's kid. So he's got the length to play outside, but we can move him inside too. Can track the ball, phenomenal ball skills.
All right, another guy at wide receiver, Tyler King.
Speed, man. I mean, you talk coming out of the Houston area, Aleif Taylor. I mean, this is a guy that's like a 10-300, 20-point in the 200, which is elite. And that was, you know, last year as a junior. What he's going to do this year in the state meet is going to be incredible. He's a slot. He's got really good hands. Be able to run the jet sweep with him. Really excited about him.
So it looks like with both those guys, you've added some speed there at receiver.
No doubt.
Got to have the big boys up front. 3 offensive linemen. We'll start with Seth Martin.
So Seth Martin, we're able to get him. He actually came on our very first visit. There were 4 guys that came, and he's from Everman, which is right down the road from me. They play really good football. Tough kids come out of that program. I think the great thing about him, he could play all 5 positions. Now, lengthwise, I see him more as a center guard, but athletically, he can play all 5 positions.
All right. And then we've got Caden Weatherby.
Caden Weatherby, so went out of state to get him from Colorado. He's a guy that I think he played guard, but has the length that we want him to play tackle. He's a mid-year, so really excited to get him in, get him around Coach Barlow, get him stronger, and get him ready for spring ball.
And that's a position, really, too, when you can get them in mid-year like that, it makes a big difference.
Huge.
Doesn't it? Yep. And then final offensive lineman, Sheridan Wilson.
So Sheridan comes from a storied program. Argyle, you know, they got beat this year. That was kind of a shocker, won the state championship last year. So he's used to playing and winning football, and that was really important to us. And then the other thing, he comes from a football family. His dad played at Auburn. He's got good length. We look at him as playing tackle. But the good thing is he could play guard or tackle, but has the length to play tackle.
All right, there are your six new Red Raiders on offense. You said we're not done yet. What are you trying to fill maybe between now and February?
We would, you know, I was really pushing hard to sign four high school offensive linemen. Mm-hmm. We're kind of going to regroup today and see some of the guys that maybe didn't sign or some of the guys that we had relationships with to go into February, because there's going to be some guys out there that didn't sign today that are really good football players.
All right, when we come back, we've got 13 new defensive players. We'll talk about them here on the Texas Tech National Signing Day Show.
We are not going to take a back seat to anyone or any program in this country.
Texas Tech's success today and in the future is a tribute to our joint love of the university, our joint commitment to what it can become and what it represents.
You know, I owe a lot to Texas Tech. You know, so much of who I am and what I am and what I've been able to accomplish has resulted from the, you know, things I learned and the things I did and the things I, and the people I met when I was at Tech. And so, you know, when I trace things back, it just all comes back to Lubbock. And so, you know, I just sort of feel an obligation because of that to give back to the place that helped me so much. And I hope that the gift itself is impactful and helpful. It's beneficial, like I said, to the West Texas community and to Texas Tech. And, you know, it really brings something to a lot of people.
Welcome back to the Texas Tech 2022 National Signing Day Show. Robert Giovanetti with Texas Tech football coach Joey McGuire. We talked about the offense in the previous segment. We've got 13 new defensive players. Was that something when you guys came in, you said, obviously, we need to fill some holes here on defense?
We did. You know, the biggest thing that we wanted to do, and I think you're going to really see that in this class, is we wanted to get some length in the defensive line. And the four guys that we signed have got great length and some big bodies. And whenever you put on the tape and see their highlight films, they get after the quarterback.
All right, let's start with one of those guys, Joseph Adedire.
Yeah, so he's coming from Mansfield Summit, another program that plays really good football. They got beat last week in the round four, in the state semifinals. And tough kids. Like, when you go watch them practice, they are very physical. They like to hit. Joseph is an edge rusher. I had a really good relationship with him coming in. He also has a great relationship with our new D-line coach, Coach Fitch, and he's an edge guy. Like, you're going to see him come off the edge and really get after the quarterback. And we felt like we needed a speed rusher. And I think the great thing about him, he's a mid-year, so he'll be here in January. And really excited about that.
Yeah, hearing that a lot, right? That's a good theme to hear about these mid-year guys coming in. Next one, we got Harvey Dyson.
So Harvey, I've known Harvey for a long time. His dad actually graduated from Cedar Hill. Really, my very first year at Cedar Hill, so that's kind of aging me a little bit. But another kid, he can play inside or outside. He played outside this year for them. He can grow into a defensive tackle, but another guy that's got really good length. Had two interceptions, dropping out in pass as a defensive lineman. So really athletic and a guy that really loves football.
All right, next we got a guy that's going to be on the all-name team, Sincere Massey.
Ah, my guy. So Sincere, that's one thing that you're going to see when you meet Sincere and some people he's posted on social media. The guy's 6'5". His arm length is 82 inches. Wow. I mean, he is NFL measurables and has a motor. You know, that's one thing. Of course, I have a love for Cedar Hill kids because I was there for so long. But when you play in that program, you've been in the weight room and you love playing football and have won a lot of football games. So really excited about him.
And you know those kids are going to kind of understand what Joey McGuire expects.
No doubt. They've kind of been through some of the off-season mental training that we'll do. It was different because it wasn't my voice, but they're going to be used to it.
And last defensive lineman, Trayvon McAlpine.
Centers hate to line up against this guy. You know, he's playing inside, big man, 6'3", almost 6'4", almost 300 pounds already. Another great thing about him, he'll be here at midyear. So they're going to move in on January 8th, and he's going to be here. And another guy that had a great relationship with Coach Fitch, and we were able to get him.
Four new linebackers in this class, Tavares Elston Jr.
Another guy, turn on his tape. I mean, one of the coaches actually said he plays with hate in his heart. I mean, he is literally one of the most physical high school kids I've ever seen in my life. The first three plays, I turned to Blanchard. He showed him to me. I said, what am I watching? I mean, are we not offering this kid? What are you doing? I watched the rest of it. Like, I went and watched all his game tape, and I'm like, this kid is like a human highlight film. The really cool thing about him, I think he can play that Will linebacker, but he could be like a strong safety in this defense too. Can really run well, tracks the ball. But I'm going to tell you, turn on those highlight films. He's a dude that plays hard.
How long does it normally take you when you see a guy to go, hey, he can play for us?
Well, I like to watch like a profile tape. So it's game tape and highlight kind of mixed together. With him, literally, I'm like, what are we talking about? Like, if you turn on his highlight film right now and you watch the first three plays, the problem is it's like 10 minutes long and they all look exactly the same.
All right, let's go to another linebacker, Ty Canna.
So Ty is coming from probably one of the greatest programs in the state of Texas, Katy, and one of the best defensive minds in the state of Texas in Gary Joseph. Mid-year, so he'll be here in January. The thing that I love about Ty is he loves playing football. He's very serious about what he wants to do. He's going to come in, he's going to study. He reminds me a lot of some of the guys that I've coached over the years that just excel not only athletically, but the mental part of the game. He's going to play really, really fast because he sees things so fast.
Another Cedar Hill connection, Demetri Moore.
So what's really cool about Demetri, and it was great, you can see it on social media, Jalen Peoples is his little brother. He signed, and Demetri had already signed, but they were both at the ceremony together. Demetri was on my last team that I coached at Cedar Hill. Very long, athletic, Will linebacker. You know, pushing 6'3". He was all SEC his freshman year. And so just a guy that's going to be able to come in, run sideline to sideline, has already graduated with like a 3.5 from Vandy. You know, a real smart guy. And, man, he's really fired up. Of course, be here because he's a mid-year guy. Transfer will be here in January.
Okay, and our last linebacker of this class, Ben Roberts.
Ben is one of my guys that I met before I came here. Huge upside because of his length. I mean, he right now, and when you look at him, you're like, man, this dude, I don't even know if he's shaving yet, and he's 6'3", 215. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this kid has got some really, really good length. He's played safety and linebacker. I see him as a Will linebacker, but if he keeps growing, there's no telling if he ends up on the edge or if he ends up at Mike linebacker.
All right, we got five DBs in this class. Another great name, Hutt Graham.
Hutt. So Hutt's playing in the state championship game tomorrow. He plays quarterback and DB. Again, I met him before I got here. The staff had him. I thought that BJ, one of our GAs, and Coach Wilson, one of our GAs, did a great job of already having a great relationship with him. Versatile player. He's going to play DB, but he's one of those guys that go over and play on the offensive side of the ball at some point.
Yeah, I saw you tweet at him, go win a state championship.
No doubt. That's what, hey, and what's really cool is like when you're talking about teams like Cedar Hill, you're talking about teams like Katy. Now with Hutt, I mean, those guys that are Sheridan at Argyle, those guys are used to winning. And, you know, we want to bring that, you know, that it's not acceptable to do anything but win.
All right, let's go back to the DBs. I'll probably get this name wrong. Marion Horn?
Horn is actually, so here's what's really cool about him. He won the MVP on the offensive side of the ball. And so he actually in the state. So he actually plays running back. He can play receiver. For us, we're going to start him off at DB, but what's great, he's going to help Coach Perry tremendously on special teams and return games. Got great hands. Phenomenal family. I was really excited to get them to be a part of the Red Raider family.
Okay, let's stay at the DBs. Landon Hullaby.
So Landon, I've known Landon and his family for a long time. His older brother plays for a team in the conference that will remain nameless. And so was able to recruit him and got to know them, just incredible people. He's a mid-year. We were able to get him. He was going to another spot. We were able to get him to come to Lubbock. Very physical safety, can really run. When you look at him, and some of the older guys met him this past weekend, and they were like, does he play linebacker? And I'm like, no, he's a safety. And I think he could play all three. He could play a boundary safety, a free safety, or a strong safety just because of the way he runs.
That gives you a lot of versatility. Yes. Got another mid-year transfer, Tyler Owens.
Tyler Owens. So Tyler Owens has been one of my favorite guys. The cool thing about Tyler, you go back to him in high school, I mean, he's almost 6'2", 205 pounds, and ran a 10.3 in the state track meet, 100 meters. Can really, really run. He's a guy that can play strong safety, that boundary safety in like a nickel or dime package. You actually put him, because of his size, you could put him in the box and play will if he's got to cover somebody out of the backfield. Really excited. Again, like you said, a mid-year. Coming from Plano East, and we're really excited about him.
And here, the last one, that Cedar Hill again, Jalen Peoples. Yep. You mentioned him earlier.
So I've coached all, now I'm going to get to coach all four brothers. Three of the four won a state championship with me. Jalen, you know, he was young whenever I left Cedar Hill. All of them have always said his entire life he's the best one of the four. We're going to find out. Played corner, had huge, huge interceptions the last 2 years. His last game returned a kick for a touchdown, so actually can really, really run. I think he'll be able to help in special teams as a returner. I think that's kind of one of his underrated qualities, but a kid that just loves football. I mean, he's seen his older brothers all play in college, and now what's cool is he's going to get to play with Demetri. It's going to be a lot of fun.
The best one, maybe, right?
Best one.
The head coach is always going to be very happy with this class, but let's take a look from the outside. When we come back, we'll be joined by Max Olson, senior writer from The Athletic. He'll sit down with our Drew Ingraham. You're watching the Texas Tech National Signing Day Show.
Max, thanks for joining us, but I do have to ask you, of all the days of the year, where does this rank on your most favorite?
This is a wild one. I enjoy getting up at, you know, 6 a.m. and checking, you know, staring at TweetDeck all day, seeing where everybody's going and following the TV announcements. And, you know, I'm glad this is, it was a little bit crazier last year because we were still in the middle of the season when we had the early signing period last December. So I'm glad we're kind of back to normal here, you know, with the recruiting cycle, where you know, players could finally go out, take campus visits again, and coaches could get out on the road for in-home visits and all that. So good to have a more normal you know, recruiting cycle in some ways, and certainly this Texas Tech staff has done a really nice job.
Without question. So Max, you've had a ton of experience following Coach McGuire, watching his impact. What can Tech fans, what can they look forward to being excited about for a Coach McGuire-led football program?
I've known him since he was a high school coach at Cedar Hill, and certainly there's a difference in being a DFW high school football coach and being a head coach in the Big 12. But, you know, I think that you've seen the impact that he had at Baylor and on multiple coaching staffs and how successful those programs have been. He's learned from some very good ones in making his transition to the college level. And one thing I know about Joey McGuire from visiting him in his office in Waco, it's covered with pictures of kids that played for him in high school. It's not about him and his fame and his glory and his wins and losses. It's about, you know, helping student athletes and turning kids into men. And I think that genuine, you know, love for the kids that play for him, you see it with all of his teams. And I know Texas Tech players are going to play their butts off for him, because he's just one of those guys that fires you up.
There's no doubt. There's no lack of enthusiasm when it comes from Coach McGuire and his love for football. So Max, we're looking at this recruiting class coming in. As you look at it and you're seeing it, what do you see in Coach McGuire's inaugural class that excites you?
Well, you saw him hit the ground running, certainly. And I think even before the introductory press conference, they were picking up new commitments. And, you know, these are, in college football, these are really tough classes to pull off, these transition classes. You want a full year or more to develop these relationships with players and parents and high school coaches and really have a lot of chances to evaluate and feel really good about the players you're bringing in. And that's what makes these classes tough. I think that this staff, first of all, he put together a heck of a coaching staff that knows the state of Texas, knows people throughout the state. So I think that helps you a lot in the evaluations. You're not just taking guys because you found them on a website. You really know who you're bringing in here. And, you know, I think they've done a great job here in a short period of time. And that's, in some ways, that's why you make an early coaching change, is to try and get a head start here. I think they've taken advantage of their time and put together a good class. And you know, I think that when he got to Baylor, they went through the same thing. And that transition class, which are usually bad, very successful. Big reason why Baylor's been, you know, playing for Big 12 titles. And so if you get this right, if you bring in the right kind of kids, and they have the opportunity to earn some playing time early on, it can be a great foundational deal for your program. So hopefully they hit on a bunch of these guys.
Absolutely. It was amazing seeing, as the press conference was taking place, social media for some of these recruits was changing with announcements. And it was great to see that immediate impact that Coach McGuire brought to the program. As we look into this class a little bit more specifically, are there some impact players that you see that Tech fans could really look forward to dressing out for next year?
Yeah, I think you start on the defensive line and you know, bringing in Zarnell Fitch, I think is a fantastic hire. Really one of the best talent evaluators in the state when it comes to defensive linemen from his time at TCU. And he was able to bring Joseph Adedire with him to Lubbock. And I think that's a really nice pickup. I would be very encouraged about the future of this D line, not just in this class, but in future recruiting classes at Texas Tech, because you know, Fitch is the real deal. I think that's going to be really impressive. I thought the pickup of Ty Kanan was also a really nice one at linebacker there. He was committed to USC, and you know, that's another coaching staff that, you know, went through transition there. And certainly we've seen a lot of linebackers from Katy be very productive at the college level. That's a great program in terms of developmental players there. So, you know, I think defensively they've picked up some really nice pieces here, and I'm interested to see what they do with Tyler Owens as well, the Texas transfer, and kind of the role that he plays within you know, that defense, and kind of that's a very talented former five-star recruit who I think in the right role could be really a really interesting piece.
Max, can't thank you enough for your time helping us out, walking us through this this exciting inaugural signing class of Coach McGuire. Thank you for joining us and appreciate your insight. Once again, Max Olson, senior writer for The Athletic. Thank you so much, Max.
Thanks for having me.
When we dream our dreams about being the very best intercollegiate athletics program in the country, it's not possible without the level of support and engagement that Dusty continues to step forward and provide time and time again.
I want to win. I want Tech to be recognized with the top programs in the country, and to do that takes funds, takes facilities, takes commitment.
Welcome back to the National Signing Day Show here, Texas Tech 2022 National Signing Day Show. 19 new Red Raiders. This guy's been the busiest guy in town, maybe in the state, Joey McGuire. We just heard from Max Olson. Always good to hear a perspective from a guy like Max.
Very well respected around the nation. I've known him for a long time, and he does a great job of covering. Really, he covered high school football. He's covered college, and does a phenomenal job.
I don't want it to get lost in what we happened. I don't know. I think 34, 35 days you've been on the job, and you've had a very short staff, right? You've been adding staff as you've gone on, and so this was done. I don't know how you'd want to say it, but at 3/10 speed of what you guys can do. So you got to be pretty excited of where you're going to be when your whole staff gets here.
Really excited. I mean, I don't want to take away from anything from the on-the-field staff because they did a phenomenal job. But a lot of credit goes to James Blanchard and Cody Belair. Those guys have come in from day one. You know, James was on the plane with me, you know, and so really from day one. And so what those guys have been able to do of getting us on the phone and getting people here for officials, Kate and one of our student workers, Presley, those, I mean, you're talking about putting together that we had 4 one weekend, and we had 13 visitors one weekend, and then this last weekend we had 5. And so it was, there was a lot of work that went behind the scenes to jump from a class that I don't know where we'll end up, but where we started to where we'll end up was a huge jump for this program.
Any kind of a guess you can give us, a number we'll see before sign by February, how many more you might add?
We want to add, I would say, at least 2, and we're really going to focus on the offensive line and maybe add, but I would take 3. I mean, the one thing about us that you'll see a lot of over the next few years is if we're going to miss, we're going to miss with big, long, physical guys. So we're going to take defensive linemen and offensive linemen. We're going to win up front.
Your social media game has been on point. How's your Texas Tech experience been?
It's been incredible, man. I mean, just like every day is something that you love this place even more. You know, and what's cool is the new staff coming in, again, they're like, Joey, this place is incredible. People are so excited. And I said, dang right they are. And they got a reason to be, but we're going to make sure it translates through spring football and into the fall.
Hey, for our season ticket holders or wannabe season ticket holders or maybe season ticket holders, we've talked a little bit about that in the show, but you're going to get on the train now, right?
You should, because you're not going to have a seat. If you don't get on now, then you're going to be listening to it from outside or watching it on TV, and I'd rather have them. You know, we got 7 home games. Why not make this the toughest place to play in the nation? I mean, it should be. We're going to work our tails off to do our part, and we need the fans to back us up.
Coach, glad you're here. Congratulations on this class.
Thank you very much.
Thanks to Drew Ingraham and Max Olson as well. For Coach Joey McGuire, I'm Robert Giovanetti. Thanks so much for joining us here on the Texas Tech 2022 National Signing Day Show.